I wrote this one for all the people that protect us, be it local policemen or military, but this one's called All the Worry and the Waiting. And it's actually written for the people that live and love those people that protect us. So thank you to all those people. She's paced the floor 1,000 times. Fights with her own imagination. Looks out the window in search of hope. Silence feeds her desperation. She knew the risks that were involved when she gave her vows to Johnny Law. He's out serving and protecting. She's just worrying and waiting. All the worry and the waiting. She puts herself through. All the worry and the waiting. Praying that he comes home safe and soon. She lies on his side of the bed. Stares at the ceiling fan above her. She checks the clock and tries counting the sheep. She tosses and turns but just can't sleep. All the worry and the waiting. She puts herself through. All the worry and the waiting. Praying that he comes home safe and soon. She hears his truck pull in the drive. She feels the weight come off her shoulders. As he comes in, she starts to cry. Rushes over and just holds her. All the worry and the waiting. She puts herself through. All the worry and the waiting. Praying that he comes home safe and soon. She knew the risks that were involved when she gave her vows to Johnny Law. He's out serving and protecting. She's just worrying and waiting.
One more.
This one I haven't played in a while. This one's called Real Cool Dude. And I came up with this idea. My wife was dropping me off at the airport, and there was a homeless guy riding his bike, and he had like a milk carton zip tied to the handlebars. And I'm like, ooh, that stuck in my head. And as I got on the plane, I started writing it. But nobody really wants to hear a song about a homeless guy. So I saw it's all been all over the internet. Yeah. I guess. No, he actually had a refrigerator. Yeah, on a bicycle. So this is called Real Cool Dude, but I tried to make it Nashville friendly, so here it goes. Got a milk crate he found in a parking lot, zip tied to the handlebars. On a bike that he rides with a sign that reads Real Cool Dude. He pedals round the neighborhood, says the exercise does him good. But we all know how he likes to socialize. He quit driving a car about a year to the day. Seems his eyesight slipping away, but that doesn't slow him down, and he never complains. You see, he's more than just some old guy riding a bike. He's a man that used to tuck me in at night, taught me how to drive a car and use power tools. He used to mix peas in with my applesauce, made it perfectly clear that mom was the boss. Yeah, that's my dad, a real cool dude. Yeah, that's my dad, a real cool dude. Before he leaves the cul-de-sac, puts on sunscreen and a baseball cap, says he doesn't like to wear a helmet, it looks uncool. And it was down to the grocery store, just down the road and a few blocks more, where everybody there knows him by name. He sees more than just some old guy riding a bike. He's a man that used to tuck me in at night, taught me how to drive a car and use power tools. He used to mix peas in with my applesauce, made it perfectly clear that mom was the boss. Yeah, that's my dad, a real cool dude. Yeah, that's my dad, a real cool dude. Funny thing about the bike that he rides, back in the day, well, it used to be mine. And him and I, we made that sign when I thought I was a real cool dude. Guess the bike's got some memories, it might even be our legacy. If that's all there is, well, that suits me fine. Because he's more than just some old guy riding a bike. He's a man that used to tuck me in at night, taught me how to drive a car and use power tools. He used to mix peas in with my applesauce, made it perfectly clear that mama's a boss. Yeah, that's my dad, a real cool dude. Yeah, that's my dad, a real cool dude.
Thank you. Thanks, Max. Thanks, Kingshead. Appreciate it. Thank you, everybody, for showing up.